Welcome back to the channel. If you guys would like to see what small rifle primers end up working best in my 6.5 Creedmoor reloads, stick around. Welcome back to the channel. If this is your first time here, welcome. And if you guys want to learn what loads work best for me, the tools I use to make my group smaller, subscribe to the channel and leave your feedback in the comments section to help me and the rest of the community improve our load development. Guys, probably looking at the screen, it's no shock that this week's video we're going to be talking about small rifle primers. If you're a fan of the channel, you're going to know that this is a follow-up video to the large rifle primer test that we also ran in 6.5 Creedmoor. If you're not familiar with 6.5 Creedmoor, this may come as a shock to you that there is actually some cases that use small rifle and other cases that use large rifle primers. When we first initially started loading, we were using Hornady brass, which is a large rifle primer brass. And now that Lapua has come out with their 6.5 Creedmoor cases, they have small rifle primer pockets. That out of the way, I will put a card up on the screen. If you guys would like to check out the large rifle primer video, I encourage you to do so. You'll understand a little bit better about why we ran this test and what we're actually going to talk about today. Okay guys, without going into too much history here, I hope, we'll just do a quick covering that basically a couple conversations have led me to question the usage of standard primers in my 6.5 Creedmoor reloads. Some advice that I got from a couple people had intrigued me to actually try and test some Magnum rifle primers in my reloads. That's what we did, and lo and behold, when we ran the large rifle primer test, we did end up finding actually the best standard deviation from the Magnum rifle primers. So when we got the Lapua brass, it was only natural we needed to test the same thing and find out. So basically, guys, what we did is run the same test as before. I'll put up on the screen our reload information for those of you who might not have caught that video, but basically, the difference between the two tests is obviously the size of the primer and the brass. Obviously for this testing, we use the Lapua brass and 6.5 Creedmoor. This is actual 6.5 Creedmoor brass, not reformed from some other caliber. Where this does differ slightly is this brass was actually only neck sized. I'd already neck sized it and I didn't feel like reworking the entire thing a third time. We used the same load as before, 41.3 grains of H4350. The cartridge overall length we utilized was 2.852 inches. 140 grain ELD match was our projectile, Hornady part number 26331. As some of you may know, this is actually one of what I will refer to as the match loads for my rifle. I've had extremely good luck with it in the past, and I've had significantly, repeatably good groups with it. That is basically one of the primary reasons why I utilize it for the test vehicle for this testing. I will say that when we ran the large rifle primer test, it was slightly cooler outside, so that may have something to do with the slight velocity difference that we see. However, I honestly think it's probably more likely, if you've seen the Lapua brass video comparison that I did on the channel, if not, I'll put a card to that up. You should go check that out. The short story is, Lapua brass actually has a slightly smaller case volume, and because of that smaller case volume, you're going to see a slightly higher pressure for the same given charge. When I show you guys the velocity data, you're going to see it is slightly higher than what we saw. The old testing averaged somewhere in the ballpark of 2650, give or take, and this loading for the same powder charge is actually a little bit closer to 2700. I don't know what else to tell you. If you want to know information about why we did this, go back and watch the large rifle primer video. But for those of you that are up to date, let's just get into the data set. I will have one quick note before we start off here, guys. If there is any primer that I would give any slack to at all in this testing, it is the CCI BR4, which are starting. Mainly why I say that is I only warmed up the rifle with 4 rounds previous to actually starting this testing. So it is possible that the barrel was not completely warm yet and might have slightly negatively affected the velocity of the CCI BR4 numbers. But guys, the data is how it is, so you guys can interpret it any way you like. Now guys, for this testing, same as we did before, we shot 5 rounds of each primer with the same identical charge, the same identical projectile, loaded the same overall length. The only difference between these loaded rounds should have been strictly the primer utilized. So starting off the CCI BR4, the velocity we achieved was 2679, the standard deviation was 13, extreme spread of 31, but the group size of 0.367 MOA. The CCI 400 with 2694 feet per second, standard deviation of a 13.3, extreme spread of 35, 0.494 MOA. The CCI 450s, velocity was 2697, standard deviation down to 7.9, extreme spread of 18, and a 0.62 MOA group. For the wildcard S&B guys here, actual velocity was 2710, standard deviation was 4.1, extreme spread of only 10, and a 0.719 MOA group. For the Winchester small rifle primers, the velocity achieved was 2693, standard deviation was 8, extreme spread of 17, and a .690 MOA group. For the Fed 205 match primers, actual velocity was 2694, standard deviation of 11.9, extreme spread of 27, and a .622 MOA group. For the Fed 205 match AR primers that we had, almost identical velocity of 2695, standard deviation of 7.1, extreme spread of only 16, and a .437 MOA group. The Remington 7.5 BR primers, actual velocity was 2697, standard deviation of 5.8, extreme spread of 15, but a 1.030 MOA group. So guys, I'm sure you'll draw your own conclusions, so I'll try not to have too windy of a summary here. One of the notable missing primers is the actual Fed 205 regular. I could not find a Fed 205 on the shelf to save my life. So the Fed 205 match AR primer will have to fill in for it in this case. The additional primer that we didn't have a chance to test in our last round was the actual Remington. Between the two tests here, I actually ran into some Remington primers. Certainly a bench rest primer that's under 3 cents is a reasonable product to check out. In addition to it, it certainly had good results today. So guys, you can analyze this any way you like. More than likely for long range, though the standard deviation will follow, extreme spread is the biggest deal here. The by far winner in that case was the Dark Horse S&B primer. Guys, these are a 2 cent primer. I regularly find these for $20 for 1,000. And it did a great job. It actually did a reasonable job in the large rifle primer test. It did not get the number one slot there, but with a standard deviation of only 4.1 and extreme spread of 10, it certainly won the contest today. Not too far behind it here, the Remington 7.5 BR, the new guys to the show, a 5.8 SD with an extreme spread of 15 isn't too bad. And it was interesting to see the Magnum primers right there in the fight. The Fed 205 Match AR, the Remington 7.5 BR, and the CCI 450s all right there, right on top of each other as far as the data is concerned. So I'm sure you rerun any of these tests, those could switch at any given time. When I initially started loading the Lapua Brass, I was using the Fed 205Ms, and I was a little bit disappointed with the standard deviation, extreme spread numbers of loads I was getting, and I was certainly hoping for better numbers than I was getting, and hopefully this primer test will help me get there. One of the things to talk about, I will put up on the screen what the brass looked like. I really don't think this is a hot load, but when you look at those primers, you will see there is some primer cratering, and even the Winchester small rifle primer, if you're looking closely there, you'll actually see that my firing pin punctured one of the primers from that testing. Whereas this load, guys, would have not shown any pressure signs at all in the large rifle, we certainly did get a little bit of primer cratering. Really no other pressure signs there. Pause it and stare at them as long as you like. I really don't think this is pressure here. If you guys are a Ruger Precision Rifle guy and you guys have been using this brass, if you guys have any info on that, I'm certainly interested to hear about it in the comments below. Point me in the right direction. So guys, if you got any questions about what we did today, please post those in the comments below. If you're new to the channel, hit that subscribe button. Hit the bell icon to get notified when I post a new video. If you guys liked today's video, please hit the like button. And until next week, stay safe in small groups.